Everyone and welcome back to another session of Daily Current Affairs by SSB Crack Exams. I am Chetan Apurab and I'll be taking you today's session for 2nd of June. So let's start talking about SSB Crack Exams. So this is a one-stop solution for all the major defense-related examinations like NDA, FCAT, CDS, etc. For more details regarding the courses that we offer, you can visit our website learn.ssbcrackexams.com. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel for regular video updates regarding current affairs and other defense-related videos. You can also follow us on Instagram as SSB Crack Exams, and don't forget to download our Android app from Google Play Store, that is SSB Crack Exams. Now we shall start our session with the question of the day from yesterday's session. I asked you guys about what are biorepositories, and many of you have also answered in the comment section. The correct answer to this is C. Biorepositories is a biological materials repository which basically collects, processes, stores and distributes biospecimens, which is a key word here, to support future scientific investigations. So basically samples from various organisms, be it humans or various classes of organisms in animals and as well as plants, those samples are stored at any particular place, that is biorepositories, and that the only purpose for that is for future scientific investigations and further research and development in biotechnology sector. Right, now let's move on to our next and the first article for this for today. So PM Narendra Modi addresses Spik McKay's international convention. So before we discuss what he addressed, first of all let me tell you about Spik McKay. So basically this is a short form for Society for the Promotion of Indian Classical Music and Culture Amongst Youth, right? And what is this Spik McKay? So this is basically a voluntarily youth movement which promotes Indian classical music, classical dance, Indian folk music, yoga, meditation, crafts and other aspects of Indian culture. Basically it promotes the Indian heritage that we have inherited from a very long time, from ancient time. It is also a movement with chapters in over 300 towns all over the world, right? Not just India but all over the world. Right? And Spik McKay, it was basically established by Dr. Kiran Seth, who was a professor from IIT Delhi, and it was established back in the year 1977 only, right? Further, in the address by Prime Minister, he said that he basically appreciated the fact that even under these trying circumstances of current crisis going on, which is COVID-19 pandemic and nationwide lockdown, the spirits of the musicians remained undeterred. This statement by the Prime Minister comes after the fact that there are many, you can say, online or virtual conferences, or you can say concerts have been held by various artisans and musicians and all those people who are related to this particular sector, which of course to cheer up people and to spread positivity among the positivity in the environment, right? He also said that music has not only been a source of happiness but also a means of service and form of penance. Now let's move on to our next news. The next news is about the PM has also launched launched Champions, which is a technology platform to empower MSMEs, that is micro, small and medium enterprises. This is a full form for MSMEs. Now what is this Champion? So this stands for creation and harmonious application of modern processes for increasing the output and national strength. So the name itself is self-explanatory. It is a technological platform which will be going to work in the favor of MSMEs, and that too to empower the MSMEs, right? The detailed objective basically you can say for Champion or this particular platform are three major ones, that is grievance redressal. So redressing of grievances from various sector, basically in the MSME sector, from various enterprises, further to help them capture new opportunities whichever is available in the market, and also to identify and encourage the spark or to maintain the motivation in them to grow ahead, right? Now that's it from this particular news. The next news is about the 15th Finance Commission, which is currently in progress, and it holds a meeting on the issues of air quality in urban areas. So this is the first time ever that they have held a meeting regarding the air quality in urban areas, which has been a serious issues, especially in the metropolitan cities like Mumbai and Delhi NCR region in more particular, and major cities of Uttar Pradesh. Now officials held a detailed meeting. So basically the 15th Finance Commission held a meeting with द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरमेंट फॉरेस्ट एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज विच वॉज ऑल्सो हेडेड बाई श्री प्रकाश जावड़ेकर हु इज द यूनियन कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर मिनिस्ट्री. This report 2020 and 2021 was the first time, like I said, that any commission, any previous finance commission has given attention to air quality index as a major focus. And this finance commission had not only recommended grants for 2020-21, but also provided roadmap for its award period. Right? The commission is currently deliberating the recommendations to be made for the next 5 years, starting from 2021-22 session. To 25 to 26, right? We all know how serious this air pollution or air quality issue is in currently in India, and especially the northern part and northern states. And it's a good sign that institutions like Finance Commission is actually giving emphasis and actually focusing on these topics also. Now, moving on to our next news. Next news is about the Kisan credit cards, which will be launched for 1.4 crore dairy farmers as well. So now dairy farmers, which are not, you can say, registered for Kisan credit card earlier, now they will also be registered and they will also, they can also avail the benefits of Kisan credit card from now on as per the government campaign. The government will provide around 1.5 crore KCC, that is Kisan credit cards, to the dairy farmers which belong to any milk unions and milk producing companies or any cooperatives within the next 2 months, that is starting from 1st June till 31st of July 2020 this year. This for this particular campaign, two departments, that is Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying and the Department of Financial Services, are working in association, and they have already circulated many application format and basic procedures and protocols that had to be followed by the dairy farmers to get on board for the to avail this particular scheme of Kisan credit card, right? And these formats have been circulated to the State Milk Federation and the milk unions of which these members are part of. Under the dairy cooperative movement, approximately 1.7 crore farmers are associated with 230 milk unions in the country. So huge amount of rural households will be benefited directly by this. So what actually will be the benefits to them? So basically, by Kisan credit card, they will get instant credit for money up to any, up to of course a certain limit. By that, of course, the liquidity will also increase, and the market will feel liquidity. There will be liquidity in the market, which will of course boost the rural economy, which is very, very important at this point of time for the entire country. Now moving on, and we shall end our session with the current COVID-19 situation in India. So as of 2nd of June 2020, at 8 a.m. the total number of active cases was 97,581. The good news is that the cured number of cases or the number of patients who are discharged is also increasing significantly, and it has reached 95,526. The total number of deaths, unfortunately, is close to 5,600. Now, it's quiz time, guys. So just one question from today's session. SPICMACAI's International Convention is related to which of these following sectors? So Indian classical music, Indian classical dance, Indian folk music. So all these three are correct. And apart from that, yoga and other things were also there. I have told you in this particular session, you can go starting time of the video, and you can watch the session now. So the correct answer for this is of course option D. Now moving on to our next segment, that is the question of the day. The question of the day for you guys is, what is this Kisan credit card scheme under which now the dairy farmers will also be able to avail the benefits of Kisan credit card scheme? So you must know about Kisan credit card scheme. So that is why I have put here in the question of the day. Write your correct answer in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. And also, till the next session, thank you. Jai Hind.